Hello, Megamaniacs. This is Mr. MegaManFan for the PC Engine Files. If I haven't articulated this lately, one of the reasons that I do this show is to expose PC Engine, or if you prefer, TurboGrafx-16 games, to a wider audience that might not have seen them before. And in the case of the PC Engine in particular, to people in North America who might not have played Japanese exclusive games like the one we're showing today, Bari Bari Densetsu. Now, I know the algorithm on YouTube would tell you, talk about popular things or current things. Talk about Sonic the Hedgehog. Talk about Mega Man. Talk about Mario. Talk about the current topics in the gaming world. Whatever controversies are going on with Blizzard, Activision, and Ubisoft, and Konami. But that's not me. That's not what I do. Not saying it's not what I'll ever do. But I would rather do the deep dives into things like Bari Bari Densetsu that are fascinating to me and hopefully fascinating to you as well once I share them with you. Now, according to the PC Engine Bible, which hilariously uses the term gubbins in their article, which I've only ever heard from Octavius King, this is based on a manga, and it's something of a rare breed, according to them, a motorcycle racing game, but I think you can glean that from the footage here. But let's go on. They say, quote, "You can guess how it works. There's a world GP mode where you compete in a variety of races, and a travel mode that lets you pick a track of your choice. I would call the travel mode more like practice for the World Grand Prix mode. When you pick a track in the travel mode, you just race it over and over again until you get down the curves and the turns and how to accelerate and when to slow down and try to get the best lap time possible before you move on to actually competing in the World Grand Prix circuit." And here's where they mentioned the gubbins. Quote, "Also to consider is the gubbins that make up your bike, such as tires, engine, brakes, etc., as those have an effect depending on the type of course and the weather conditions. Races start with a qualifying lap that lets you get the feel, followed by the race proper. You are then placed and can hopefully move on to the next country." Now, for me at least, the only gubbins that I worry about while playing Bari Bari Densetsu is the automatic or manual shifting, because I find that letting it automatically shift is a lot easier, even though I'm sure people who've played this game more than I have would argue that manual gives you better control and allows you to accelerate more quickly and complete laps faster. Since I'm not an expert, and I was never good with a stick shift in real life anyway, I will just go ahead and defer to auto in most cases when and where it's available. As mentioned, Bari Bari Densetsu, which roughly translates to Vroom Vroom, a legend, is based on a manga that was published between 1983 and 1991, over the course of 38 volumes, becoming an award winner at one point in 1985 when it got the Kodansha Manga Award for Shonen. It's also been compared to Initial D, since both of them focus on high schoolers and street racing, although in this case it's obviously motorbikes instead of cars. It's funny that in retrospect the manga were blamed for causing people to become street racers trying to emulate the characters they saw in the novels, as opposed to the novels being inspired by real-life street racers. They were even given a special name in Japanese culture called Bozozoku, which I'm sure I'm pronouncing wrong, and they were seen as a huge social problem in the country of Japan, because they were doing dangerous things like riding around mountain curves at high speeds and potentially into oncoming traffic or into each other, or wiping out and causing accidents and causing emergency services to have to be called to save them. So if you picture the culture of Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift, which obviously is not an accurate representation, but an Americanized, westernized look at street racing in Japan, that might give you a glimpse into it. Or Initial D, as mentioned, which was adapted from a manga into an anime series, that might give you a glimpse of it as well. None of it could be considered authentic or accurate, not even by a Westerner such as myself, who is admittedly not knowledgeable to a great degree on these things, but I would take it with a grain of salt, like, this will give you a look at that culture, but it's not going to be the actual culture. It just gives you a hint or a taste of what it's like. Just as Bari Bari Densetsu would give you a hint of being a motorcycle racer, but obviously not what it's actually like to put your hands on the handlebars and throttle up and gear shift and go around hairpin turns at breakneck speeds and try not to wipe out. This only roughly approximates it in a video game form, and you have no sensory feedback to the kind of things that you're doing, so it's all your eyes and your ears and the controller in your hand, and whatever you can glean from that is just a little taste of what high-speed motorcycle racing in Japan would be like. And of course, they take it around the world in this game. You're not just limited to Japan. Once you go on from practicing in the travel mode to competing in the World Grand Prix, each course is a different country. So they're exporting this culture around the world, quite literally, which coincidentally, they do in the manga as well. They move on from street racing to competing in professional motorcycle racing events, so they level up over time, and so do you while playing this game. Initial D was not the only one to get an anime adaptation, though, because there is actually an OVA, or original video animation for short, which is not the same as getting a full anime series, but can be considered a one-off or a feature length. They're usually not like an hour or 2 hours like you would think of a feature film, though. But in this case, more like 30 or 40 minutes, maybe an hour at the most. And they take bits of a manga and adapt it to an animated form. Sometimes they're self-funded, sometimes they're crowdfunded. Sometimes a studio will do like a test pilot with an OVA, like, let's try this and see if it would work as an actual anime if we decide to go that route. Or sometimes the opposite happens, where an anime was already successful, but the fans demand more, so they're like, okay, here's an OVA for all the people who wanted some more of this. Now you got it. Enjoy. And in fact, Bari Bari Densetsu got two OVAs, the first one being 50 minutes in length and the second being 54 minutes. So there you go. And the characters from the manga / OVA carry over into this game as well, such as Gun Koma, who I'm racing as right now. He rides a Honda CB750 as well as a Suzuki GSXR, and Ai Itu, who is Gun's girlfriend, and Hideyoshi Hijiri, who is Gun's friendly rival, and Hiro Okita, who is Gun's best friend. There's a whole cast of characters if you read the manga or watch the OVAs, and I don't know if the manga has been translated to English, if 38 volumes was enough of a run for it to be profitable or popular enough to translate to an American audience and find some traction there. Possibly. I think series with less known and less amounts of episodes or OVAs have been translated before. Like Chobits, I know there was a manga series for that, and I think there were only a handful of anime episodes of Chobits, like maybe 7 DVDs total with like 2 episodes each and a bonus feature. So that's obviously not a high amount of material, but it got its own manga that was translated from Japanese into English. So if Chobits could make it to the United States, then I suspect Bari Bari Densetsu could as well. But speaking from personal experience, I have never seen the manga at any bookstores, at Books A Million, at Barnes & Noble, and if it's available, it's probably someplace online like Amazon. But I don't know, because I haven't bought it. I would, however, like to track down the OVA. I'm sure someone like WriteStuffAnime.com, hashtag not sponsored, they would probably have it. And in fact, my friend Sir Crunch might already have these OVAs, so I should probably ask him, because he has a substantial collection of anime from just about every series imaginable, and quite an impressive collection of figures and memorabilia as well, which, if you've ever seen any of his videos on my channel, you would already know, or you could go to his channel as well, SIRKRUNCH. Also, hashtag not sponsored, but he's been a friend of mine since high school, so it's a long time going, and he's an awesome dude. So drop by his channel and check out his anime unboxings and anime content sometime if you like. He doesn't upload super often, but what he does have is pretty cool. And that's what I would say about Bari Bari Densetsu as well. It's pretty cool. There's not a whole lot of motorcycle racing games available for PC Engine or TurboGrafx-16, so if you're going to go that route, Bari Bari Densetsu is certainly not a bad way to go. There's a bit of a learning curve, no pun intended, on racing around these track curves, but it takes you a while to get used to the handling of the bike, and once you do, then you can start customizing it with whatever options you like and fully enjoy your gameplay experience. But I would say start out with the basic bike, get used to the way it handles on the D-pad of the TurboGrafx-16, accelerating, decelerating, and all that. And then once you get into your comfort zone, then go for the gold, figuratively or literally. It's also a fairly inexpensive game if you're looking to buy it. $15 loose, $20 complete. Shipping may vary. $21 shipped for a complete copy. Mint, never opened, allegedly, is $80. I wouldn't buy that, though, because a lot of those end up being resealed. So if you're looking for a new PC Engine game, this is not only a good entry, but an affordable one. I'm Mr. MegaManFan. This has been the PC Engine Files. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something. I feel like I did in the making of this video, and I hope you'll check out this game too.